Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, let's see how different robot brands represent their robot paws using Euler angles. Let's get started. As mentioned in the last video, Euler angles are a way to represent the orientation of an object in space. Different robot brands use different flavor of the Euler angle to represent the robot paws. So in this video, my goal is to help you clarify all of that and see how you can leverage RoboDK to make things way easier. So here we have our example. The only thing I did is I kind of shown the robot that were previously hidden. So if I double click the Kuka robot, we discovered in the last video that we had Z, Y prime, X prime prime. So that's pretty normal. If we double click on the UR robot, you have U, V, W. So that's another way of representing the Euler angle. You see here we have pretty much the same orientation. So I can kind of bring this one here to the same orientation. Oops, home here. I'm gonna go home, and if I want to have the exact same orientation, I can just press Alt and then rotate that here to zero. So we have minus 90, zero, minus 90. And here those two are exactly in the same orientation, but here we have minus 69, 69, minus 69. So same orientation, completely different set of values because the flavor or the method of expressing the Euler angle is different. I have to say that I don't like the UR way of representing UR angles much. So what I generally do is I press here the drop down menu. You can see here, first of all, you have UR degrees and UR rad. So internally, Universal Robot uses radian. So you could have come here and use the radian option to see minus 121, 121, and minus 1.21. But that's not really intuitive either. So what I would generally do is I would either use ABB Kuka Natchi or Fanuc Motoman here to represent the Euler angles. So the thing you need to keep in mind is this is just a representation. It won't impact the program you are generating at the end of the day. So even if you use here a more intuitive flavor of the Euler angle, you will still generate proper code for the robot. So RoboDK in the background will take care of converting this back to the right Euler angle method with the UVW. If I was to open here the Fanuc robot, you see here we have X, Y, and Z. So remember when we had some primes, so with the Kuka robot, I'm gonna compare it with the Kuka robot at every single time step. So here we have Z, Y prime, X prime prime. Here we have X, Y, Z. So first of all, things are inverted, but here it means that we are always comparing with the rotation or rotating around the original base reference frame. So we're not rotating around the newly created frame. So if I go here and I rotate around the x-axis, it's with respect to the x-axis of, I'm gonna bring that back to, let's say, everything at zero, like that here. So if I rotate around the x-axis, I'm not at a good spot, so I'm just gonna bring that back to zero, zero, and I'm going to give myself a bit more room to play, so here. So if I rotate around the x-axis, it's around this x-axis here. If I rotate around the y-axis, it's the y-axis here. The z-axis here. But if I rotate a bit around the x-axis and then a bit around the y-axis, as you can see, it's not rotating around this y-axis, it's rotating around this y-axis here. So it creates some kind of weird, but sometimes a bit unintuitive way of rotating. So if you always work with Fanuc, you say, oh yeah, I'm used to that, I understand it, it's intuitive for me, fine, use this method, I'm not preventing you from doing it. But sometimes it might be a bit confusing. And here, if we rotate around this, the z-axis, you see we're rotating around this z-axis here instead of rotating around the z-axis of the newly created frame. And then if you start to go there, that might start to be a bit confusing, because now it's rotating around this axis here, then the first x-axis. So yeah, so it's valid, it's a valid method, but I do believe it's a bit more confusing than using the zy prime x prime prime. Dem Academic has kind of a in-between way of representing the Euler angle, similar to the ABB Kukanachi. It's x, y prime, z prime prime. So instead of going z, y, x, it's going x, y, z. It's not a big deal, honestly. You just need to get used to it a bit. So if I rotate around, let's say here, it's going to be rotating around the x-axis, then the newly created y-axis here, and then the newly created z-axis. So once you understand that, it's fine. If you have something like that here, 45, 40, and 20, you can switch from one to the other without any problem. So you'll see that sometimes the numbers are way more, let's say, are round in one format and won't be round in another one. So if I go Fanuc Motoman here, it's something else. If I go Stobli Mechanic, it's 45, 40, 20. If I go ABB Kukanachi, it's like 42.901, 10.67. So from one format to the other, it can be a bit strange, if I can say, because of the conversion. So that's something you need to make sure when you look at the program we are generating for your robot, it might look different. Like, why do I have these values here and I don't have the same value within RoboDK? It might be just because of the Euler angle format of display. And it's really like what I want to emphasize on. It's the way we display Euler angle. It's not necessarily the way it won't affect the program you will generate at the end of the day. So last thing I want to show you here is, if you go under tools and then options, you have here default Euler angle. So by default here, if you create a target and there is no robot, so by default RoboDK will always take the default Euler angle format of the first robot you bring in as the default Euler angle format. But if you don't have any robot inside your station, it will default to RX, RY, RZ, which is kind of the same as the Fanuc Motoman, so RX, RY, RZ. So this is the default or generic Euler angle format your RoboDK uses, but you can easily come here and just decide to instead use RX, RY prime, RX prime prime, or use here, you have Adek, Kamau, and Kawasaki that uses RZ, RY prime, RZ prime prime. And you can even go for quaternion for ABB. So yeah, ABB, you have kind of two ways of representing the Euler angle. You have the, I would say human readable or human understandable one, and the real one that is used within the controller, which is the quaternion. So you can just kind of select one or the other. Okay, so I know this one was a bit technical. I think it's important for you to be able to differentiate between the different flavor of Euler angle used in robotics. At some point, maybe I will do a video specifically on that to go more into the details of the maths behind the scene. But it wasn't my goal here. Was just wanted to clarify that and avoid some questions or avoid you wasting your time trying to understand why you have a certain set of value in the program you generate and then another set of value inside the virtual environment here that might just be because you don't use the same way of displaying the Euler angle. And this is what I want to emphasize on. It's just a way of displaying the Euler angle. We will always generate the right format for your robot when it comes the time to generate the robot program. Okay, so in the next video, we will talk about singularities, how RoboDK detect those singularities, what are the singularities, and how you can avoid them. So I hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys.